God, I thank you in the name of Jesus for your word. I thank you for what you're doing in the lives of your people. God, I thank you. Oh, God, I thank you for the middle of the sea, God. Oh, God, I thank you that you have not stranded us, God. You are great, God, mighty, strong, powerful, wonderful. God, I love you, God, everlasting. Good, more than good, good. Help us to see the good in you, God. The good, God, that makes you, makes us more than a conqueror. The good, God, that makes us able to do all things. The good, God, that makes us able to see the good in the situation. And we know all things work together for the good as we put it together. Good when things, when the enemy comes in, adds up with. And we know all things, and all those things come together to work out for good. I thank you, God, for the knowledge that I must have, good and bad, in order for me to be blessed, in order for me to see my best in the wilderness. I must still have mess to deal with. I must still have a mess to deal with, because I will not appreciate the bless unless I have mess. Hallelujah to God. I think that Adam and Eve were drama queens. Oh God. So I thank you, God, in the name of Jesus for your word and for what you're doing and for what you're doing. Even with the rain, God, the rain comes, God, the rain comes. But as that rain is coming down, God, that's a natural implementation of what you can do in our lives, God. Rain down on us, God. Rain down on us, God, and rain on us, God. Hallelujah. We wait for you to rain the latter rain. Rain on us. Pull the reins if you got to, God. Pull the reins on us, God. Some of us don't see what we're walking into. Pull the reins on us, God. We think it's a great thing, but it's a thing that will lead us into the lion's mouth. God, I thank you for the protection that you've given me, God, so that I can see my in the midst of the sea, God, for who it is ought to be, God. I thank you. Heavenly Father, oh God, I thank you. You never leave us alone, God, in the wilderness, God. We give you a yes, God, a nevertheless, God. Again, I say yes, God. I give you a nevertheless, God. I want to be more than a conqueror, God. I can do all things through Christ, God. I thank you for it, God. Oh God, I thank you for giving me life and life more abundantly. You got not let the thief take me, for he comes to steal, rob, kill, destroy, but you have come that we may have a life and life more abundantly. And so we thank you, God, for it. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. God, I thank you for it. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. And amen, amen, amen. And amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. God, I thank you for it. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, say it for me. Oh. Still say a lot? Good. Round two. Round two. Why? Because the thief cometh. Not but for two. That's a lot of words, big brother. The thief cometh not but for two. I got a question. Why didn't he just say the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy? The thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Because what he did was he simplified why he came. He could have said, the thief comes to steal, kill, and to destroy. But I have come that you may have life and life more abundantly. He said, I come that you may have life and life more abundantly. But he says, the thief cometh not, but for to steal, kill, and destroy. Why the three? Don't leave that there. Why the extra warning? I believe that Jesus wanted us to know that they ain't coming unless you got something for him to take. He ain't coming. He ain't coming. He does not come. If you see him in a situation and the situation is negative, please stop attributing a credit to him and giving him extra glory and extra gold and saying, oh, this is the thief, when it is not. I had to get on Facebook. God said to do it. I had to go on Facebook and all my social medias. He said, please tell them to stop giving extra credit to the enemy. Please tell the church to stop fighting the battle that says that if you want to separate your identity and call yourself something that you should not be calling yourself, then that makes you evil. That does not make them evil. What that makes them is hurting. God said, mind your business. We have a hard time doing it. Stuck in my business. A lot of us that are stuck in the wilderness and don't know it. And what's dangerous about that is we have eyes on everything. The enemy from the wilderness will allow you to see everything. But what he does is he puts on you rose-colored glasses. Oh, I like this prescription. This prescription gives me the right prescription. The prescription is lying to you. It's showing you is these people that you think love you, hate you. And these people that you think have the best for you will tell you anything that you want to hear to keep you from walking into the ministry. You will not ask God or ask somebody that you know hears from God. You will go to ask the witch at Endor. You are looking to the witch at Endor and calling them your prophet. And when you get to them, they tell you exactly what you want to hear. Why? Because you paid them. You know how you paid them? Your friendship. I'm friends with you. Let's be best friends. What do you think about this thing? You can't ask nobody that's living in the natural world with a natural mindset that don't want God. You can't ask them any spot about any spiritual thing. They have no knowledge of it. They are not prepared. They are not giving God glory. What you are doing is releasing your destiny into the hands of Satan. Can it be changed that way? Yes. The enemy is the prince of the air right now. The enemy has no idea when God is coming back or Jesus is coming back. God does. The enemy is the prince of the air in the air at the second. At the second. At the second. And then the next second, he's the prince of the air in the present. That's why he prepares a table before you in the presence of your enemies. They have to be present in the presence to get the table prepared before them. The enemy, the only one that walks inside and outside of time is God. So God knows how the destiny works. But if God has revealed to somebody, listen, tell them about their ministry. Tell them about their destiny. They come and tell you about your ministry and your destiny. You release it to somebody that's not spiritual and they speak against it. You have opened it up like Pandora's box and allowed the enemy to spit all over it. And then when you leave, you don't close it. Don't tell me you pray over what you just heard with them and said amen and sealed it and said whatever God wants from it, it is so and it will be so in my life. You have not prayed when you started talking to them and you don't pray when you leave them. People bug out laughing with me because when I get on the call, Miss Carol, I pray before I talk to her. And I know she's about God. Absolutely, we have prayer. We're going to talk about chicken. I don't play. Because she may need to hear something. And I need God to be able to work with me immediately at an immediate situation, an immediate way, an immediate time to speak to her. She may not be speaking what she's really feeling about the chicken situation in the church that may deplete it. But God may tell me, Jen, you need to speak right into that situation right over there. Tell her this. But if I'm not praying up and I went on a call, oh God, and she's stuck in the wilderness, I will end up seeing, or I can end up seeing, just like she's seeing, with the same rose-colored glasses. The only way you're sure that you keep the enemy out is that you bring God into it. And you don't know who's for God and who's not. And so I gotta give credit to the people that did it to me. What they did was they asked me to speak and just come up with a conversation and just record a video and talk to them. They wanted to pick me up and train me in preaching and in ministry. And I said, okay. And I cleared it with my pastors and I gave them a video. I made a video and I gave it to them. And it's still on Vimeo. There's nothing wrong with the video. What they did was they looked at me and they ghosted me and they pulled away from me completely. And then they had a councilwoman who works with them call me and say, I am, instead of using anointed oil, I use snake oil. No biggie. I've been rejected so many times since I've been in Hagerstown. No biggie. That video was done with snake oil. But I do believe that is what God said. He said they're jealous. When they realized that, because he told me sit down and just speak and open up your mouth and just speak into the video camera. So I did. I sat down and I just started talking. And that came up out of me. There was no study. There was no Bible opening. There was no Bible ministry. There was no writing in the Bible and taking notes. You got to do that. I don't. For whom the sun sets free. It's free indeed. And I gotta be free from the pages. My ministry is not sitting down doing video. My ministry is standing up. Wherever I be, I have to walk back and forth. And wherever I be, I walk back and forth all day. I'm walking in a teardrop formation right now. A teardrop formation. Because somebody needs to shed tears to get rid of what's going on inside of them. He has me right now walking in teardrop formation. But I'm walking back and forth over and over again in teardrop formation. Since what, 6:30 this morning? What is it, 8 o'clock? Teardrop! Drop the mic. Teardrop. Your teardrops make me drop the mic. Could it? could it be? My teardrops will make me drop the mic. I can't shed a tear over what they said. I laughed at it. God told me immediately what they were doing. I laughed at it, and they posted on a Facebook. It's funny. Because I'm not hurt by it. I've been hurt by the best. And they do not exist in Hagerstown. You know, there's not no one in Hagerstown that can hurt me like I've been hurt. Oh, God, I'm not.